Thank you for the invitation. I'm working in the Strategic Research Services, and I was chairing the working group who was building up the data policy of Oulu University, and I will present it now. And it's also, as obvious, openly accessible at the university web pages, but I bet that you don't find it. Everything is open, but not always so open. You can try if you have a computer. So, Oulu University has accepted the new strategy at the beginning of this year, and related to this strategy, university also accepted the open data policy, and Oulu University decided to have a position as an internationally significant science university, which means that we are doing internationally important research. And then we should follow the international standards on open data policy. And we also are a strong innovative university. We have a large medical faculty, university hospital, and therefore the legitimate constraints, which are somehow restricting the opening of data, must be carefully considered and taken into account. So we should protect the immaterial property rights and personal privacy, which is within that data. And in our working group, we were studying the existing data policies of the Finnish universities. I think Jyväskylä was the first, then Helsinki, and also some foreign universities like ETH Zurich in Switzerland and United Kingdom. And in United Kingdom, they have very developed evaluation procedures and open access policies and so on. And we made the conclusion that this concordate on open research data formulated in United Kingdom by the funding bodies, universities and research institutes is a good model, and they have been thinking the open data policy in very wide way, how it benefits the university stakeholders, but how also the researchers' rights are taken into account. And then we proposed to our rectorate that that principles of the concordate on open research data will be taken as the data policy of the University of Oulu. And that is, there is the website where you can find the concordate. It's a about 20 pages document, and very good. They have considered many aspects in opening the data. And so shortly, the principles. First is that the opening the research data is a good thing. It shows that the research has high quality, it helps innovations, and it safeguards good research practice. So before you can open your data, you must somehow organize it so that it can be opened, and then you must, before you start doing research, think how to do it so that good research practice is adopted. And this means, the second principle, that you must start it early. Already the students must understand that when they do some projects, they must follow the open access principles and high quality research principles so that people can check what they have done in their projects and how the data is collected and how it is verified. So we come to the third principle, data must be curated. Because if you just give your data to some data bank and nobody understands it, it is not really open. So it must be accessible, one can access it and one can use it. So the data is open when the others can use it. Which means that it is expensive. If you have, like in experimental research, you might have enormous data sets nowadays, when it is so easy to collect data. Then you must, when you start doing research, you must also think how much does it cost when you keep your data somewhere and when you guarantee that it is in data archives for a long time. Nowadays, for instance, these data banks which are collecting DNA sequences, for instance, they are drowning in data when the sequencing equipments are more and more efficient, so there is more and more data coming out. And the same is in physics, space research, and so on. So easy to collect data, it's more difficult to preserve it so that one can use it. And then this principle number five, that is very important. The research data is not always open. It must be restricted, but the restrictions must be justified. And one has to show why it is restricted. The first is, of course, the personal privacy. If you do medical research, then it is obvious because you need the permission to collect patient data. But it is the same in pedagogic studies, humanities, if you are making interviews of people, you cannot put those interviews to YouTube immediately, but you must collect the data and make access to those. And then, of course, the creators must have the right to the data, what they have collected and what they have opened. And so if you use other researchers' data, you must give the credit to those who collected it. And then what is somehow raising questions is this, at which moment the researchers should open their data. If you are doing long-term data collection, for instance, some research station about climate or other nature events, you might not want to publish the data immediately. You might follow 10 years, 20 years, or until your retirement. That must be then discussed with the publishers and with the owner of the data, which is usually the university. And then there must be education, which is going on today. And then this must be part of the research quality assurance of the universities. And then just shortly, at the University of Oulu, Management Group in Research, Tutkimuksen johtoryhmä and Research Council are the coordinating bodies. But then, of course, libraries, IT services, research support services, they all must give the hand to the researchers so that I think everybody is involved in that. And Oulu has made the decision that we strongly recommend national data services and international services as a place where you store your data. And especially CSE is offering many ways to help researchers. But in each faculty and Corvas facility, we must define a person in charge who is familiar with this policy and facilities and can give advice to researchers. And then the national goal is to be the leading country in the world in open science, and we must contribute. So we are talking about opening the data, but that is actually was the last step. First, we must somehow have the data curated so that it makes sense to open it. And the metadata, which is linked to that, must be defined, and the data archives must be registered. And then only you can start thinking, how do you open it? And so our first step is to think of data management plans, registration of data, curing the data, and then opening the data. And we all must be involved in this. And if you didn't find the data police, this is the web address for this English site. So thank you.
Thank you, Sinikka.